Wave nature of matter. We have studied that light behaves as both particle and wave, that is, it has dual nature, and we can call it as dual nature of radiation. That is, we treat light as waves while explaining the phenomenon like reflection, refraction, interference, diffraction, and polarization. Similarly, light is treated as particles in the form of photons while explaining photoelectric effect. Later on, in 1923, the French physicist Louis de Broglie gave a hypothesis that as light behaves like wave and particle, that is, it has dual nature, same way, all the matter or particles exhibit wave-like properties under suitable conditions. Or, that means, particles can also have dual nature. The wave nature associated with matter particles in motion are called matter waves or de Broglie waves. The wavelength of matter waves are called de Broglie wavelength. De Broglie gave an expression for wavelength of the particle by considering Planck's quantum theory and Einstein's theory of relativity. According to Planck's quantum theory, the energy of a photon is E is equal to h nu, where h is Planck's constant, nu is frequency of photon. From Einstein's theory of relativity, E is equal to mc square, where m is the mass of the particle, c is the speed of light. Therefore, equating h nu is equal to mc square, or m is equal to h nu by c square. The momentum of a photon is given by p is equal to mc, that is equal to h nu by c square into c, that is equal to h nu by c, or p is equal to h by lambda, since c is equal to nu lambda. Therefore, p is equal to h by lambda, or lambda is equal to h by p. That is, wavelength lambda of the photon is specified by its momentum p. De Broglie assumed that the equation for wavelength of a photon is completely a general formula and it can be applied for particles also. So, for a particle, momentum p is equal to mv. Therefore, lambda is equal to h by p, that is equal to h by mv. This wavelength is called as de Broglie wavelength. Now, we will write de Broglie wavelength in terms of kinetic energy k and potential v. We know that kinetic energy of a particle is k is equal to half mv square. Multiplying and dividing by small letter m, that is the mass of the particle, we get k is equal to half mv square into m by m, that is equal to half m square v square by m. But momentum p is equal to mv, therefore kinetic energy k is equal to p square by 2m, or p square is equal to 2m into k, or p is equal to square root of 2mk. Therefore, de Broglie wavelength lambda is equal to h by p can be written as h by root 2mk. So, this equation is the equation connecting de Broglie wavelength and kinetic energy. Now, when a particle of charge q is accelerated by a potential difference v, the kinetic energy gained by the particle is given by k is equal to half mv square, that is equal to v into q. Therefore, lambda becomes lambda is equal to h by root 2 m v q. For an electron, charge q is nothing but E. Therefore, lambda is equal to h by root 2 m v E. So, this equation is the equation connecting de Broglie wavelength and potential V. In the above equation, H is a constant, that is Planck's constant. Its value is 6.63 into 10 raised to minus 34 joule second. M is mass of electron, 9.1 into 10 raised to minus 31 kg. E is the charge of electron, 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. Therefore, substituting the values, we get lambda is equal to 12.27 by root V angstrom unit, or lambda is equal to 1.227 by root V nanometer. So looking at the equation, lambda is equal to H by root 2 mk. We can say that de Broglie wavelength is smaller for a heavier particle, that means if the mass is high, or for a more energetic particle, that is kinetic energy is high, means de Broglie wavelength will be small. Therefore, macroscopic objects in our daily life does not show wave-like properties. This is because the de Broglie wavelength is so small, which is of the order of 10 raised to minus 34, that it is beyond any measurement. But for subatomic particles like electrons and protons, the de Broglie wavelength is of the order of 10 raised to minus 10 meter, so it is significant and measurable. Next, we will see Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. According to Heisenberg's uncertainty principle, both momentum and position of an electron or a particle cannot be measured simultaneously. There will be some uncertainty in position, that is delta x, and uncertainty in momentum delta p. The product of delta x and delta p is given by delta x into delta p is approximately equal to h cross, that is equal to h by 2 pi. So, according to this equation, right hand side is a constant. So, if delta x is equal to 0, delta p will be equal to infinity. Similarly, if delta x is infinity, delta p is equal to 0. That means we cannot simultaneously measure the position and momentum of an electron. Next, we will see the experimental demonstration of wave nature of electrons, that is Davison and Shermer experiment. The wave nature of electrons was first experimentally verified by C.J. Davison and L.H. Shermer in 1927, and independently by G.P. Thomson in 1928. The experimental arrangement is shown here. F filament F, that is a tungsten filament, which is coated with barium oxide, is heated by a low voltage power supply, LT. So, electrons will come out, that is due to thermionic emission. The electrons emitted by the filament are accelerated to a desired velocity by applying a high voltage V between the filament F and anode A by a high voltage power supply. The anode A is in the form of a cylinder with fine hole along its axis. The electrons passing through the hole of the anode form a fine collimated beam. This beam of electrons fall on the surface of a nickel crystal. The electrons are scattered by the atoms of the crystal. The intensity of electrons scattered in a given direction is measured by the electron detector. This electron detector can be moved in a circular scale and it is connected to a sensitive galvanometer. The deflection of the galvanometer is proportional to the intensity of electrons entering the detector. The apparatus is enclosed in an evacuated chamber. By moving the detector on a circular scale, the intensity I of scattered electrons is measured for different angles of scattering, theta, that is the angle between incident and scattered beam of electrons. The variation of intensity I with scattering angle theta was obtained for different values of accelerating voltage V. That is, in this experiment, the voltage was varied from 44 volt to 68 volt. Now we will see the observation. It was observed that a strong peak appeared in the intensity of the scattered electron for an accelerating voltage of 54 volt at a scattering angle theta is equal to 50 degree. The appearance of the peak in a particular direction, that is theta is equal to 50 degree, is due to the constructive interference of electrons scattered from different layers of atoms in nickel crystal. From electron diffraction measurement, the wavelength of matter waves is found to be 0.165 nanometer. The de Broglie wavelength associated with electrons for voltage 54 volt is given by lambda is equal to 1.227 by root V nanometer. So substituting V as 54, we get lambda is equal to 1.67 angstrom unit or 0.167 nanometer. That is, there is an excellent agreement between theoretical and experimental value of de Broglie wavelength. So, this experiment confirms wave nature of electrons.